It looks a little odd, a surgeon seemingly flailing around, unless you realize that he's working in a virtual operating room, handling virtual instruments, and about to do a virtual knee replacement. Think of it as the surgical equivalent of a flight simulator for pilots, with just as much safety at stake.
Patients can be sure that their surgeon or their trainee has gone through a simulation many times and has quantitatively shown that they can perform a procedure safely.
Dr. Peter Skolko is the co-chair of the BioSkills Education Lab at the Hospital for Special Surgery. He says virtual reality, like first-year resident Dr. Christopher DeFrancesco is using, is particularly well-suited for orthopedic surgery because many procedures have well-defined steps that a budding surgeon must master.
From my perspective, as an early trainee, there's a good value in this for just me learning how things go together. At least knowing that I'm putting my hand in the right place, I'm picking up the right instrument, helps me to be confident when the first time I'm doing it in real life.
It's been a very long time since I assisted in surgery, so I felt compelled to give virtual reality a try. It takes some getting used to, but I can see how valuable it would be for training. Dr. Skolko says it's also valuable in deciding when a resident is proficient enough to move on to more complex procedures. The company that designed the VR system says this is just the beginning. Next generation virtual reality will include tactile feedback so the surgeon can actually feel tissues. It's an important skill in surgery. After that will be augmented reality, where x-rays and other data can be superimposed right on the surgical field in a live procedure. Dr. Max Gomez, CBS 2 News.